to Tanzania, Lord have mercy. You know, while we are slacking in Nigeria and so many other countries, the man is doing wonders. Have you heard about the new president of Tanzania? They call him the bulldozer, and rightfully so, because the man is bulldozing corruption, laziness, and overspending among government officials. Ladies and gentlemen, meet the man that gladdens my spirit. I hope that all African presidents are watching. Well, they're probably not watching, but anyway, I hope they can learn a few lessons from the man, Dr. John Magufuli. He's a farmer's son whose first real job was a school teacher, and then he educated himself as an industrial chemist and eventually became Tanzania's Minister of Public Works before winning the election in November of last year. Yeah, just last year. You would not believe all that the man has done. The first thing he did was to suspend the Independence Day celebration. He said, what are we celebrating when people are dying of cholera? I was like, whoa, how many people have died of cholera in Tanzania? What? 74 people? How many people have died in Nigeria? My father and my God, thousands of people. Boko Haram has killed thousands of people in Nigeria, and we did not suspend any party or ceremony. Even our new president was in Ogun State, you know, celebrating in Ogun State after the incident that happened in Dalori. Meanwhile, a president canceled Independence Day celebration because like 70 something people were killed by cholera. So they were supposed to spend 4 billion Tanzanian shillings on that ceremony. But Magufuli said, no. You see, that money should be used for the expansion of a 4.3 kilometer section of the road from Morocco to Mwenge in order to ease traffic congestion. Tell them, that is what I'm talking about. Now for the Independence Day ceremony, the man commanded that everybody, that people should get out of their houses and go and clean their streets and all the corners in order to stop the spreading of cholera. He didn't stop there. He himself came out, Mr. President himself. He got on the streets, cleaning up the streets. My eyes got big when I saw that video.
When we nominated Dr. Magufuli to be our candidate, we knew the style, the type of leadership that he represents. We needed, his style and his way of doing things. We expected him to do exactly what he's doing.
When some Nigerian officials, even those that are not even presidents, they're not president, when they will be feeling pompous, because of what he did, his own officials also got on the street, cleaning up the street. Imagine what will happen the day we see Oga Saraki with a broom, or Oga Dino Melaye, or Senator Ben Bruce. Ah, that man's very, very loud, very loud. On Twitter. Anyway, the man banned all foreign travels by public officials, public servants, except when it is essential travel and they must get permission from him or from the chief secretary. In fact, on the 21st of November of last year, a group of 50 officials were going on a tour of Commonwealth countries. The president cut down the list from 50 people to 4 people, and he saved the government 600 million Tanzanian shillings.
Recently, during the Commonwealth conference that President Uhuru Kenyatta attended alongside other senior government officials, his Tanzanian counterpart slashed the size of delegation to the conference from 55 to just 4, thereby saving millions of shillings.
Money they would have spent on tickets, accommodation, and per diem, you know. No more traveling abroad for all these officials. He said, well, the high commissioners and the ambassadors and the embassies abroad should be representing Tanzania when they are invited. Which makes a lot of sense. Why are they abroad if we also have to be going abroad, you know? No more first class and business class travels for all officials except Mr. President, the Vice President, and the Prime Minister. Only 3 people. No more business class flying. That means they have to fly economy. Oh my God! Oh my God! Reminds me of Thomas Sankara of Burkina Faso, no be so? Yes, that's what I'm talking about. The man has cancelled all meetings, no more workshops and conferences by government officials and public servants inside fancy hotels. He said no more inside fancy hotels. He said that every ministry has ministerial boardrooms, no be so? Use that one for your meetings. And that is what they are now doing. Soon after coming into office, Mr. President went to Muhibili Hospital unannounced. He just walked there and he walked through all the terrible parts of the hospital that they would normally hide from officials. All the dirty places, all the places where people were sleeping on the floor, where equipment were not working. After seeing many equipment not working and some patients on the floor, the man fired the director of the hospital, he fired all the hospital board members, and he ordered that all the machines that were not working must be repaired within 2 weeks. If not, he would fire the new director as well. Apparently, all the doctors knew that the machines were not working, but instead of repairing them or asking the director to repair them, they were referring patients to their own private hospitals.
Sasa huyo, ipi MRI inayofanya kazi ni iko wapi? Hospitali zote za private zinafanya kazi.
Kwa hiyo za private zote zinafanya kazi. CT scan za hospitali za private zote zinafanya kazi. Za hospitali ya hapa Muhimbili zote hazifanyi kazi.
I know that something like that is going on in Nigeria as well. No, so anyway, he gave them 2 weeks to fix the machines. But guess what happened? The machines were repaired in 3 days. 3 days. And so it is possible to repair this. And then when they opened parliament, they planned a state dinner that would cost 300 million shillings. And when he heard about it, he said, you see this 300 million shillings? Make it 25 million. Whatever we can eat with that, we will manage. Now the rest of the money, he said, they should use it to buy hospital bed for that hospital that he visited, you know, Muhibili Hospital. So they bought 300 brand new beds and mattresses and 600 bed sheets from that money. Can you imagine? They would have eaten with that money and that would have been the end of it. Now they have 300 brand new beds to admit people into the hospital. By the way, he said that why were engineers using V8 engine vehicles when they were supposed to be using pickups? He said that is more suitable for their jobs. So now they've changed all the vehicles. No more sitting allowances for officials. He said, how the hell are you paid allowances for a job which you have a monthly salary? That also applies to members of parliament, by the way. No more sitting allowances. It was so funny when I heard that the day after he was sworn in, the state house officials were showing him around, you know, his new residence, but he was not really impressed by that. Instead, he decided to take a walk to the Ministry of Finance. He got there and he told them to get their acts together. He asked why some employees were not in office yet, and I heard that since that day, the traffic jam in the mornings has really, really increased because people no longer show up late to work after Mr. President's visit. Now he ordered that no more tax exemptions for the big people. Everybody must pay taxes, including the big people. The other day, when he was going to officially open parliament, instead of him to fly the 600 kilometers, the man decided to drive. He drove the whole 600 kilometers from that to Dodoma. He has reduced his own convoy. He even reduced the presidential delegation that travels with him. He surprised everybody when he chose a female vice president. All the big boys were shocked. They were like, what? It's a new day in Tanzania. And then he chose a prime minister that nobody has heard about. They said that this guy has a reputation for hard work and no corruption. All the big guys that thought that they would be prime minister are still in shock, by the way. So after his visit to the Ministry of Finance and that hospital without announcing, all the other ministries have fastened their belts. Everybody is now hardworking, including a sector that people consider very, very corrupt. That is the port, where people normally pay bribe to get their stuff. I heard that it has suddenly become the most efficient place. No loads are missing, things are done quickly, and you cannot get your container without paying bribe. And finally, all individuals and firms that bought state companies that were privatized, they've been told to either get to work or hand over that sector with immediate alacrity, hand it over back to the government. Some of them, I heard that they've not done anything in like 20 years, but now all of a sudden, they're all awake, doing stuff. The man has literally pressed the reset button in Tanzania. It's a new day in Tanzania. His motto is Hapakazi 2. Some of you that are not from Tanzania, you probably don't understand. Don't worry, I will teach you. What that means is here, all we do is work. We serve, nothing else. Yes, his people are happy. Of course, the big people are not that happy, especially the corrupt ones, you know. But all the small people, like myself, they're very, very happy. Ugandans want their president to be like him. They wrote an article about it. South Africans want their president to learn 10 things from Tanzanian president. And of course, I want my president to learn from this man, three bosa. So the president of Tanzania, gosa, 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 eh? Now, having said that, my guy, we are very happy, we love you. You started well, please continue to do not disappoint mama. If you keep up like this, very soon Tanzania will become the best country in Africa. No, be so, you guys are not doing anything. Guess what, I'm just keeping it real.